This video was brought to you by GeneralPack.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Consider subscribing and supporting through patreon.com/GeneralPack. This is the mechanism for you to support us financially so we can continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Our corporate sponsor for this topic is AllumiaX.com from Seattle, Washington. Contact them for industrial and commercial power system studies. Types of relays and design requirements, part 2b. This is the second part of topic 2 in a series of types of protective relays and design requirements. In this topic, we continue our discussion on design, mechanism, and application of different types of relays. And in this part, we will be discussing overcurrent relays and directional relays. Now, overcurrent relays. What is an overcurrent relay? An overcurrent relay operates only when the value of current sensed is greater than the relay set value. That is essentially what an overcurrent relay is. How does the mechanism work for an overcurrent relay? Well, this relay consists of a current coil and a disc which is free to rotate between the poles of two magnets, right? When a normal current flows through this coil, the magnetic effect generated by the coil on the disc is not sufficient to move the moving element of the relay. And that means that restraining force is greater than the deflecting force, right? But the current through the coil increases, and after a certain level of current, the reflecting force becomes greater than the restraint force. As a result, the moving element starts changing the contact position in the relay. The trip circuit operates the circuit breaker, which isolates the fault. Depending on the type and characteristic of the operations of relay, they are placed in three categories. The first category is the instantaneous overcurrent relay. The second category is the definite time overcurrent relay. And the third category is the inverse definite minimum time, the IDMT, overcurrent relay. So for the first one, the instantaneous overcurrent relay is the one which no intentional time delay is provided for the operation. It operates instantaneously when the current rises to a very high value. This characteristic is usually used in the case of a short circuit fault when the relay has to trip immediately without any delay. So that's what an instantaneous overcurrent relay is used for. The next characteristic is the definite time overcurrent relay, and in this type, two conditions must be satisfied for its operation. The first condition is that the current must exceed the setting value, and the fault must persist for at least the time equal to the time delay setting of the relay. The definite time overcurrent relay characteristic are used for short circuit protection, where the relay has to trip immediately, but a certain time delay is provided to ensure coordination with other relays upstream and downstream. The third category is called the inverse definite minimum time, the IDMT, overcurrent relay, which is the one in which the operating time is approximately inversely proportional to the fault current near pickup value and then becomes constant above the pickup value of the relay. These relays are used for the protection against overcurrent faults. The inverse definite minimum, or the IDMT characteristic, is further divided into three more categories that are known as the degree of inverse curves, and they are the normal inverse, the very inverse, and the extreme inverse. An overcurrent IDMT relay may be programmed to set to work with any of these three degrees depending on the specialized type of protection that is required. So usually an overcurrent relay is used for motor protection, used against overloads and short circuits in stator windings of the motor. It's also used in sub-transmission lines where the cost of distance relaying cannot be justified, and distribution system protection. So the next part is the directional relays, okay? This type of relay employs the principles of actuation of relay, which means the action that causes the relay to operate when the fault current flows into the relay in any particular direction. So if a power flows in the opposite direction, the relay will not operate. That's the main difference between a directional versus a non-directional overcurrent relay. As far as the mechanism is concerned, consider a feeder XY that's passing through a station A. A circuit breaker in feeder AY is provided with a directional relay R, which will trip the breaker CBY. If the power flow is in the direction of AY alone, so it will only trip when the power flow is in the direction of AY and beyond, obviously, the circuit breaker. Therefore, for a fault in feeder AX, which is in the opposite direction, the circuit breaker CBY will not and should not trip unnecessarily, right? Because of the directional relay. However, for fault in feeder AY, then CBY should trip. And it's because the fault is in the direction of the relay, right? And it's in the direction of AY. So these types of relays are used in transmission lines where the power flow is associated in a specific direction, and in particularly at parallel feeders when where if a fault occurs on one feeder, then the other feeder must not trip. So also directional overcurrent relays are used in networked systems where the system are all interconnected with each other and they are not radial, or when power flow can occur in either direction of the line. Now in the next video, we will be discussing reverse power flow relays and distance or impedance relays that are used in electrical power systems and their applications as well. Now we hope you have a continued interest in this topic and in this series as either a student or a professional, and we also hope that you find this content useful and enlightening. Please consider subscribing to generalpack.com or becoming a patron at patreon.com/generalpack. Generalpack.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Thank you.